Good evening, everyone. So I think it's the fourth lecture for the topic fluid mechanics. Fourth or third lecture, I think. No? And now we know Bernoulli's law, Bernoulli's theorem. And on the basis of Bernoulli's theorem, we see some applications, practical based application. First, today we also start the practical based application also. That is called velocity of efflux, or and one part of this is also called Torricelli's law. So let's see what is Torricelli's law and what is velocity of efflux. So suppose we have a tank. Suppose we put some liquid. The best example is we can put some water. Let P naught is the atmospheric pressure. Now, H is the height of the liquid. And here, H is a height, small h, from where we create a very small hole. And from this hole, what happened? Liquid coming out with some velocity. So as the liquid coming out with some velocity, it is possible to find out this range of this velocity. But first of all, we have to find out this velocity. So this velocity is called the efflux, velocity of efflux, and Torricelli's law are special condition. So before we start, we suppose the tank is covered. So if the tank is covered, let P is the pressure inside the tank and P naught is the outside pressure, because by using machine we can create extra pressure due to which we can increase the velocity of the liquid. And let rho is the density of the water. Like you can see that municipality water, and that municipality water is distributed in so many places. So they create an extra pump, means by using a machine, they create an extra pressure so that the velocity can be, we can increase. Now, if we suppose two point A and B point, one is inside the tank and one is outside the tank. By using Bernoulli's theorem, by using Bernoulli's theorem, at A, we can use the pressure inside the tank is P naught plus the height of the liquid is rho gh. So as well as the liquid moving down, it will be moving in that side. So although there is a very less velocity of the liquid, which is we can write dx by dt, but with respect to that, the height of the, with respect to the area of the tank, as that area is very, very less, try to understand that area is very, very less with respect to that area of the tank. So the decrease of this height with respect to this velocity is very, very, very less. So because of that very less, in general, we neglect that velocity. Otherwise, we can write half rho V1 square. But as this speed is very less, so we neglect it and we make it zero. Because if we write half rho V1 square here, V1 is very, very less. So less that we can neglect it. Achha. Now, if we move on to B, my atmospheric pressure is P naught. And as outside no water is there, so water pressure is zero. And the velocity moving out or coming out with some velocity, with some speed. So we can write half rho V square. That velocity is called the velocity of efflux. So am I audible to all of you?
Yes. Yes, sir.
And the board is visible properly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So now see, half rho V square, that is equals to P minus P naught plus rho gh and so v square is 2 p minus p naught by rho plus 2 rho gh by rho, so you can cancel this rho. So v is equals to 2 p minus p naught by rho plus 2 gh. Is it okay? Everyone, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, what is Torricelli's law? Torricelli's law is a special condition. If the atmospheric pressure and pressure inside the tank is equal, if the pressure inside the tank and atmospheric pressure are equal, then that part is zero, then the velocity is root under 2gh. That is, you can say motion under gravity. You remember motion under gravity? If a particle falls from a height h, its velocity is root under 2gh. Okay?
Yes, sir.
That is called the Torricelli's law. Means Torricelli first proposed that if the atmospheric pressure and pressure inside the tanks equal, then the velocity coming out with this with the speed of gravity means rho gh, 2gh, that is called the Torricelli's law. So I think you understand what do you mean by Torricelli's law. Torricelli's law is the special condition when the atmospheric pressure and pressure inside the tank equal, then the velocity coming out from the liquid with a particular velocity, that velocity is a very special velocity. That velocity is the motion under gravity. Okay, that is called the Torricelli's law. I hope you all understand.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
And believe me, in most of cases, we use these two pressures are equal. So we get a very small portion, V is root under 2gh. And here we can use so many, we can use it in so many different way. Like, first of all, if this is the total height and if you create a hole at a height h from the top, so what about this height? This is h minus. So if this is the height, so we have time of flight, we know 2 h minus h into g from the projectile. I think all of you satisfied with my answer.
Yes, sir. Time of flight.
And this is the horizontal velocity type 2 projectile. So we can calculate the range, that is velocity along x-axis and time of flight. Here it's very easy. You can use 2gh into root under 2h minus h by g. So this gg cancels. So you have 2 root under h minus h into h is the range. Is it okay?
Yes,
so this range is very, very important. This range is very, very important. I hope you all understand up to that part.
Yes, sir.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If yes, then we can move on to the next part of this. Efflux velocity, although it's totally based on entrance exam, not based on board exam. Okay, in your board exam you have only that part. Okay, but if you want to elaborate this key, how many things you can calculate. Suppose we are creating or generating one more hole which is at a height of y from the top, and if we expect key both are in the same range, then what is the relation between y and h? Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So for that, we can say both ranges are equal. Now for the first one, my range is 2 root under h minus y into y. And the second one, 2 root under h minus h into h. So squaring both sides, 2, 2 cancel. HY minus Y square, HH minus H square. If we want to calculate in terms of Y square, so if we move in that side, HY plus H minus H square equals to 0. So I think it's a quadratic equation. Is it okay? So if we solve it, we get 2 root of y. One is h or h minus h. So I hope you get your answer. Where we create the hole so that we get the same range. Is it okay, everyone? Student, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Like, suppose the height of the tank is 100 centimeter or 1 meter. If you create one hole at 20 centimeter, where you create the next hole so that your range is same? So that your answer is, if one is at 20 centimeter, another one is where? Means if your one hole is at 20 centimeter, another hole is 100 minus 20. That means 80 centimeter from the top or 20 centimeter from the bottom. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello, is it okay? Everyone, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is one thing which is very, very important. Next thing is, we know the formula of range is, equals to 2 root under h minus h into h. Now the question is that in that tank, where we create the hole, so that the range is maximum, So for that, I have only one choice. See, the capital H is fixed. So as well as you change the height from the top, your range can be variable. Is it okay, everyone? For different height, you have different. I don't know which one is right, where we get the maximum for where we create the hole so that we get the maximum range. Is it clear? You understand my question? So for that, let's square it. So if we square this R square, we have 4 H minus H into H. So if we square with respect to H, because H is variable, so we have 2 R dr by dh, that is 4, you can write it 4 HH minus 4 H square. So 4 H is constant. You can say dh by dh minus 4 dh square by dh. So if you want to differentiate this, 4H dh by dh is 1 minus 4 into 2H. Now dr by dh, that is equals to 4H minus 2H by 2R. Now I just want to show you or introduce you one more formula, that is, if you have a function, listen properly, okay? If you have a function, because now you know very well about the differentiation and function and all. If you have a function and if you differentiate that function and if you get that is equals to zero, that means in that case it is either maximum value or minimum value. Now if you double differentiate this and if you get the value negative, then definitely it is maximum value, and if you get a positive, then definitely it is a minimum value. I hope you understand what I want to say. Is it okay? So now as in this question, the question is it is given, find the maximum range, that means that must be zero. And if you differentiate this, you get the value negative. Very simple, see, you have a negative sign. So you get the values negative. But as we not, no need to check it, that whether it is maximum or minimum, because it is already said that okay, this one is maximum value. So we just make it zero, differentiation is zero, and we get the value, which is what? Maximum value. So from this, we can say H minus 2H is equals to zero. 2H is H, H equals to H by 2. What do you mean by H by 2? So if you create exactly at the middle a hole, then your range is maximum. Is it clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
And if you want to calculate, keep when we create a hole at the middle, what is the range? If you want to calculate it, where is the what is that range? So we can use this formula 2 root under h minus h by 2 into h by 2. So what we have, 2 root under h by 2 into h by 2, that is 2 into h by 2, that is h. So your range is h. Clear? Okay, everyone. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Acha. So apart from this, you have one more question or theory, which is very, very practical based. Okay. And so many time asked in entrance exam. I just want to show you, just give me 1 minute. Yes. The question is that suppose you have a tank, okay? Total area is A, capital A, in which you have a liquid. And let capital H is the height of the water. And here you create a hole. Let A naught is the area of the hole. And H is the height. H is the height. So the water coming out or liquid coming out from this hole, you have to find out with how much time the tank become empty. I think all of you have a water tank on your roof or in on your what you say chhat ke upar jo hota hai usme, and you always understand ki after excess uses of water ki wo water tank khali ho jata hai. So you, if you want, you can calculate uska jo dekhna ek tank ek pipe se pani bharta hai aur niche mein ek hota hai jisse pani nikal jata hai. If you able to find out the area of that or the diameter of that pipe, so you can easily find out the area. So kitna se pani bahar aa raha hai aur tank kitna ka hai, mano 1000 liter ka tank hai ya 2000 ka tank hai ya 5000 liter ka tank hai. So you can calculate ki within how much time water will coming out from the tank, kitna der mein khali ho jayega, you can calculate it. So aaj hum log isi ke bare mein padhenge ki kitna time mein ye khali ho jayega. So yahan pe we have velocity, we know it, that is 2gh, and rho is the density of the liquid. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
And from the equation of continuity, one, we know one thing, area into velocity is constant. That is, if you multiply it by rho, that is mass by time, amount of liquid. So this in amount dm, you have density into volume. So if you erase this, means if you divide by density, you have dv by dt. So basically, this area into velocity is the volume of liquid coming out or coming in with respect to time. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So what we can say, the amount of liquid coming out, dv by dt, that is area of the orifice into velocity. So area of the orifice and the velocity is root under 2gh. Let it be equation number one. So as well as the liquid coming out, this liquid will moving down. Is it yes or no? Tell me.
Yes.
So let in del t time, dv amount of liquid coming out. So as well as it is moving down, so the volume is increasing or decreasing? Decreasing?
Yes, sir.
So if we suppose in dt time, that much amount of liquid is coming out. So we can say this volume, that is negative. The area of the tank is A, and the liquid coming out, let it be dh. So let it be equation number two. If we put this value here, so what we have, A dh by dt, that is A naught root under 2gh. Now, if you want to calculate the time dt, so we can move in that side, that is equals to minus A by A naught dh by root under 2gh. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So from this, we can arrange it A naught root under 2g dh by h half. What do you mean by that? A naught root g h minus 1 by 2 dh. So we arrange it. Now we can take the integration dt, that is equals to minus a naught root g integration 1 by 2 dh. Now see, when the time is zero, how much amount of water remain? Full amount of water means the whole height. Is it clear? And after time t, suppose you try to empty that much amount of water. I'm just giving you just randomly. If you want to calculate that much amount of water is empty. So let that height is so h. So what you can say, how much height remain? H minus h. If that height is h, so that much is remain h minus h. Is it clear? Or you can make it here also for no confusion. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So on that basis, if we calculate this, what happened? Although this one is not in your syllabus, so don't worry about the calculation. It's especially for entrance exam. Only you have Torricelli's law in your board exam. Okay. Minus A naught root under 2g. Now this one, what you have, h minus half plus 1, minus half plus 1, h to h minus h. So what you have, t minus 0, that is minus a naught root under 2g. Here you have 1 by 2 means 2 root under h minus a. So can we change the limit by using this negative sign? You don't get it, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Means yes or no? Okay.
Yes, sir, I got it.
For generalized form, I just write it. H minus H. So you can make that two outside also. H minus H minus H. So due to that negative, we can reverse it. So what we have minus a by a naught root under 2 by g, if we remove that negative sign, so it will be reverse, h minus h. Is it okay? So that is the time taken. So this is the general formula. Why I said it general formula? क्योंकि ये तुम्हारा मन है, मतलब एग्जामिनर का मन है. एग्जामिनर चाहेगा तो टैंक को पूरा खाली करेगा. एग्जामिनर चाहेगा बोलेगा 3/4 ऑफ द टैंक रिमेन, 3/4 पार्ट ऑफ द टैंक इज एम्प्टी. सो यहाँ पे कितना रहेगा? अरे 3/4 चला गया, h से h माइनस 3/4 h, तो बचा क्या 1/4. Are you getting my point? बोलेगा पूरा टैंक खाली हो गया. हाँ, don't get it, पूरा टैंक खाली हो गया. So capital H and small h are equal?
Yes, sir.
So then h minus h is how much? Zero ना?
Zero.
So, अगर क्वेश्चन में बोले कि हाफ टैंक को खाली करना है तो ये h, ये कितना हो जाएगा h by 2. अगर बोलेगा 3/4 खाली करना है तो बचा कितना 1/4 ना.
Yes, sir.
और अगर बोलेगा टाइम टेकन टू एम्प्टी, एम्प्टी द टैंक, तो एम्प्टी द टैंक मतलब h माइनस h इज जीरो. दैट मींस दिस इज a बाई a नॉट रूट अंडर 2 by g root h minus 0, that is, ये देखने में ज्यादा सुंदर लगता है, a naught root under 2h by g. This is the time taken to empty the tank. लेकिन इस time taken to empty the tank देखने में सुंदर लगता है, लेकिन question ज्यादा आता है general solution, general form से. मतलब half tank को empty किया, 3/4 empty किया, 1/4 empty किया, तो time कितना लगेगा? 1/4 empty किया तो ये क्या हो जाएगा? 3/4 means h is 1/4, so h minus h by 4. So you have 3/4 h, half empty kiya, h minus h by 2. 3/4 empty kiya, h minus 3h by 4. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So you can easily calculate any question from that. Iske upar kafi sundar sundar numericals bhi hai, lekin problem yahi hai ki itna टाइम कम है ना. फिर भी मैं एक तो क्वेश्चन कराऊंगा ही. यस, फर्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू रीड द क्वेश्चन एंड देन ऑन दैट बेसिस. आई कैन शो यू हाउ दिस फॉर्मूला इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Everyone, it's okay?
So question koi bolna?
Boli nahi, bolbo. The question is that a cylindrical vessel filled with water up to a height of 2 meters. Sorry. A cylindrical tank 1 meter in radius. A cylindrical tank 1 meter in radius. 1 meter in radius. तब ये है 1 meter. A cylindrical tank 1 meter in radius on a platform 5 meter high. Initially the tank is filled with water up to a height 5 meter. मतलब ये एक platform में है. What is the height of the platform? 5 meter. और टैंक में कितना पानी है? 5 meter. ओके, अब देखो इसमें क्या है. filled with water up to a height 5 meter. A plug whose area is 10 to the power minus 4 meter is removed from an orifice on the side of the tank at the bottom. Plugging मतलब यहाँ पे हमें छोटा सा छेद किया है. इस छेद का एरिया कितना है? एरिया है 10 to the power minus 4 meter square. ठीक है. Calculate number one initial speed with which the water flows from the orifice. So number one, calculate V. Number two, initial speed with which the water strike the ground. मानो यहाँ पे ground है. So with what speed it hit the ground. And number three, time taken to empty half of the tank. Time taken to empty half of the tank. See, so you have to use that general formula. इसलिए मैंने ये formula रख दिया. And the last part is that, does the time to empty the tank depends on height of the stand? ये जो tank जो empty हो रहा है, ये क्या height of the stand के ऊपर depend कर रहा है? Justify your answer. So you have 4 question and I. Anyone tell me the answer? See, it's a very simple.
You don't need so much time. First of all, here you can use root under 2gh. 2 into g is 10 into h is 5. That is 10 meter per second. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, before hitting the ground, you have two velocity. One is the horizontal velocity, that is 10 meters per second, and one is due to the height, that is vertical velocity. It is also 2gh, so 2 into 10 into 5, that is 10 meters per second. So resultant speed before hitting the ground is root under v of x square plus vy square. So you have 10 square plus 10 square. That is 10 root 2 meter per second. They ask you speed. So you just give the speed. Now the next part, time area, pi r square by a naught root under 2g, 2 by g, root h minus, you can write it, root h dash. That is also, you can write it. So pi 3.14 area is 1 square and that is 10 to the power minus 4. 2 by 10 root 5 minus root 5 by 2. Isn't it? Obhirut, is it okay? Everyone, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
धन्यवाद. ओके, नेक्स्ट वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इज वेंचुरीमीटर.
वेंचुरीमीटर अच्छा, তোদের স্কুলে এগুলো কি করিয়েছে? আমার তো মনে হয় না, তো জাস্ট অল্প অল্প কিছু করায়নি না এগুলো. ভেঞ্চুরিমিটার ফিটার করিয়েছে?
ভেঞ্চুরিমিটার করায়নি.
ভেঞ্চুরিমিটার তো সিলেবাসে আছে মনে হয় রে, এনসিইআরটি তো আছে.
থার্মোমিটার, সরি, থার্মোডাইনামিক্স এর স্টার্টিং এর অনেক কিছু ছেড়ে দিয়েছে.
আরে থার্মোডাইনামিক্স এখনো দেরি আছে,
এখন তো খালি ভিডিও দেখাচ্ছে আমাদেরকে.
ফ্লুইড বলছি, ফ্লুইড
না না, আমি থার্মোডাইনামিক্স এর কথা বলছি
না. সৃষ্টি, এক মিনিট. আচ্ছা যাই হোক, দেখ
আমাদের,
হ্যাঁ
আমাদের এখন ওয়েব স্টার্ট হবে কয়েকদিন.
আচ্ছা, ভেঞ্চুরিমিটার. সো ভেঞ্চুরিমিটার ইজ আ ডিভাইস বাই ইউজিং হুইচ ইউ ক্যান মেজার the speed of the fluid. Okay, and then that venturimeter is very very important. Why this venturimeter is very very important? I just give you a rough idea, then you understand why this venturimeter is very very important. Suppose kisi ka open heart surgery ho raha hai, to open heart surgery mein kya hota hai, heart ko bahar karke ek ek kya tum usko bolo ki ek अलग से एक मशीन बैठा के जब तक उस हार्ट का ऑपरेशन होगा तब तक मतलब हार्ट के जगह पे मशीन से क्या करता है ब्लड को सर्कुलेट किया जाता है। क्यों? क्योंकि हमारा ब्रेन में क्या है सबसे ज्यादा ऑक्सीजन चाहिए, ब्लड जो है ऑक्सीजन को कैरी करता है। अगर 30 सेकेंड तक ब्रेन को ब्लड नहीं मिले तो ब्रेन हेमरेज हो जाएगा, मतलब हम लोग कोमा में चले जाएंगे। तो यू जस्ट इमेजिन विद इन 30 सेकेंड हार्ट का पाइप को निकाल के वो लोग मशीन का पाइप लगा देता है और हार्ट ब्लड फ्लो को सेम मेंटेन रखता है ताकि मेरा ब्रेन हेमरेज ना हो। ब्रेन हेमरेज हो गया तो फिर ऑपरेशन फॉपरेशन करके कोई फायदा नहीं है। तो वो क्या करता है मशीन से अलग से उसको चलाना चलाएगा, और तो जब मशीन से चलाएगा तो मशीन में ब्लड का स्पीड डिपेंड करेगा, मेरा वेन में प्रेशर क्या है, ज्यादा प्रेशर हो जाएगा तो फिर ब्रेन हेमरेज हो सकता है, कम ब्लड भेजेगा तो लो प्रेशर के कारण ऑक्सीजन नहीं पहुंचेगा तो भी स्ट्रोक हो सकता है। तो एग्जैक्टली मेरा हार्ट जितना ब्लड प्रेशर मतलब ब्लड पंप कर रहा है या मुझे एक नॉर्मल इंसान को जितना ब्लड प्रेशर का जरूरत है उस हिसाब से ब्लड का जो स्पीड है उस स्पीड को मेंटेन करता है बाय यूजिंग द इंस्ट्रूमेंट। एक्चुअली दैट इंस्ट्रूमेंट इज उसका बहुत सारा नाम होगा क्योंकि दे आर वेरी एडवांस, बट उसका बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट है ये वेंचुरीमीटर। आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? यू कैन कैलकुलेट द स्पीड ऑफ द फ्लूइड। ओके, सो दिस वन इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। हां
सर, एक मैंने प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन छिलो।
हां बोलो।
একটা প্যারাবোলা ছিল, ওটাকে তোমার মিড অ্যাক্সিস থেকে রোটেট করলো, তো ওটা প্রেসার এট এনি পয়েন্ট কত হবে?
প্রেসার এট এনি পয়েন্ট?
হ্যাঁ,
না তো ইকুয়েশন না জানি হবে।
আচ্ছা স্যার ঠিক
আছে, তুই আমাকে পাঠাস, না হলে এইভাবে প্যারাবোলার প্রেসারের ইকুয়েশন না জানলে তো মুশকিল আছে। দেখো ये जो वेंचुरी मीटर है, जैसे हम ये एक पाइप लिया, मानो ऐसे करके, और यहाँ पे हमने ये ऐसे दो जगह पे ऐसे होल किया जिसके ऊपर अंदर
तो नल से के जल जखन बे रहा है तखन को ओटार मध्ये प्रेशर सब समय सेम থাকে
না? প্রেসার সেম কি করে থাকবে? যদি মনে কর যে তোর নলটা ভার্টিক্যাল হয় তাহলে আলাদা আলাদা প্রেসার থাকবে, স্পিড আলাদা আলাদা হলে প্রেসার আলাদা আলাদা হবে, স্পিড যদি সেম থাকে তাহলে প্রেসার সেম হবে। এবার স্পিড দেখবি যত গ্রাউন্ড ফ্লোরে আসবি স্পিড বাড়বে তাহলে প্রেশার কমবে, যত টপে থাকবে তাহলে স্পিড কম তাহলে প্রেশার বেশি। আমি যদি বার্নুলিস থিওরামকে ধরি, তারপরে হাইটেরও একটা কন্ট্রিবিউশন আছে। ঠিক আছে, তো দেখো ইয়াহা পে ইসকে আন্ডার অ্যাকচুয়ালি ক্যা হোতা হ্যায়, এক মার্কিউরি হোতা হ্যায় না, মার্কিউরি লেভেল হোতা হ্যায়। ज्यादा एरिया कम प्रेशर, ये कम एरिया ज्यादा प्रेशर। और यहाँ पे लिक्विड फ्लो कर रहा है, अच्छा एनसीआरटी में क्या किया है, ये वाला भी अलग लिक्विड लिया है। सो यस आई हैव अ रेड पेन, यहाँ पे एरिया लेट इट बी ए वन, यहाँ का जो एरिया है लेट इट बी ए टू, यहाँ का जो वेलोसिटी है वी वन, यहाँ का जो वेलोसिटी है वी टू। तो जिसका एरिया ज्यादा वेलोसिटी कम मतलब प्रेशर कम, तो ये हाइट लेट इट बी एच वन, और ये जो हाइट है मानो थोड़ा ज्यादा हाइट है, ये जो हाइट है लेट इट बी एच टू, और ये एक दूसरा लिक्विड है मानो रो एम। तो अब क्या होगा कि ये जो दोनों लिक्विड का जो हाइट का जो डिफरेंस है दैट डिफरेंस इज हाइट h, मतलब प्रेशर डिफरेंस के कारण जो मेरा हाइट जेनरेट हो रहा है, लेट रो इज द डेंसिटी ऑफ द लिक्विड, मुझे अब V1 या V2 कोई भी एक जगह पे मुझे वेलोसिटी का रिलेशन निकालना है. सो इफ वी यूज द बर्नौलीज थ्योरम एट दिस टू पॉइंट, लेट दैट पॉइंट इज बी एंड लेट दैट पॉइंट इज सी. सो व्हाट वी कैन से फॉर दिस वन, लेट द प्रेशर इज P1 प्लस एज इट इज अ हॉरिजॉन्टल, सो रो जी एच इज सेम, सो वी डोंट नीड टू राइट दिस हाफ, सेम लिक्विड फ्लो, रो V1 स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू P2 प्लस हाफ रो V2 स्क्वायर. सो P1 माइनस P2 दैट इज हाफ रो V2 स्क्वायर माइनस V1 स्क्वायर, लेट इट बी इक्वेशन नंबर 1. कैन वी राइट दिस?
यस सर.
नाउ दिस प्रेशर डिफरेंस इज द राइज इन द लिक्विड और मर्क्यूरी कॉलम और एनी अदर लिक्विड. So you can say rho m, which is the density of the liquid, that red color liquid, gh. So let it be equation number 2. So by using this equation 1 and 2, we can say rho m gh is half rho v2 square minus v1 square, equation number 3. And in some book or in some case, they use these are the same liquid. So they can use rho m, rho, they can cancel also. But according to NCERT, they put different.
Sir, height kano nila na?
Ito rho gh nilam to. Eta height nilam na kano? Eta to dekna horizontal to.
Oh,
okay. Acha. Now, from the equation of continuity, we know A1 V1 is A2 V2. So suppose mujhe V2 को भगाना है, A1 को निकालना है, so we can write V2 equals to A1 by A2 into V1, let it be equation number 4. Now, if we put the value of equation 4 in equation 3, so what we have, rho m gh is equals to half rho V2 square, we can write A1 by A2 V1 whole square minus V1 square. So from that half rho, we can say A1 square minus A2 square by A2 square into V1 square. So what about V1 square? That is 2 rho m gh by rho. And this is A2 square by A1 square minus A2 square. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So what about your V1? V1 is 2 rho m gh by rho within bracket A2 square by A1 square minus A2 square. Okay. Now, is it clear? See, A1 is the higher area than A2. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So, if we want to calculate the V2 similarly, see how you write it. You just use your basic knowledge. Rho gh by rho, these are the same thing. Only in place of A2 square, you can write A1 square. And that part is remain same. Why? If you reverse it, so then what happened? A2 minus A1, A2 is less than A1. So the within root is never negative. So you can write A1 square minus A2 square. Ye baat yaad rakhna, ye kabhi negative nahi hoga. To hamesha bada area minus chota area. V2 ke liye, mujhe chahiye A1 ka area. Aur V1 ke liye, mujhe chahiye A2 ka area. Is it okay?
Got it.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
अब देखो इसके ऊपर तुम लोग का NCERT में ही एक बड़ा सुंदर सा क्वेश्चन दिया है, तो मैं इस क्वेश्चन को रीड करना चाह रहा हूँ. क्वेश्चन थोड़ा डिफरेंट टाइप का क्वेश्चन है, बड़ी सुंदर क्वेश्चन है.
देखो क्वेश्चन क्या है
कि द फ्लो ऑफ ब्लड इन ए लार्ज आर्टरी ऑफ ए ऑफ एन एनेस्थेसाइड डॉग, इंसान को नहीं लिया है, कुत्ता को लिया है, कि एक कुत्ता का शायद कोई ऑपरेशन हो रहा है, उसको एनेस्थेसाइड किया गया है, अब उसके अंदर से मुझे आर्टरी के अंदर से ब्लड वगैरह कुछ फ्लो करना है. द फ्लो ऑफ द ब्लड इन अ लार्ज आर्टरी ऑफ एन एनेस्थेसाइड डॉग इज डाइवर्टेड थ्रू अ वेंचुरी मीटर. समझ में आया मैंने जो बोला कि ओपन हार्ट सर्जरी में ये वेंचुरी मीटर यूज होता है ब्लड को सर्कुलेट करने के लिए, जैसे डॉग के लिए किया जा रहा है वैसे इंसान के लिए तो ज्यादा किया जाता है आजकल, बहुत ज्यादा ओपन हार्ट सर्जरी का ये है और इसमें डीबी शेट्टी का नाम सबसे ऊपर आता है, इंडिया का वन ऑफ द बेस्ट हार्ट सर्जन है डीबी शेट्टी, नाम तो सुना ही होगा. अच्छा, द वाइडर पार्ट ऑफ द मीटर हैज अ क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया इक्वल टू दैट ऑफ द आर्टरी. वाइडर पार्ट जो है A1 वो है 8 mm². ठीक है. अच्छा, द नैरोअर पार्ट पार्ट हैज एन एरिया A2 4 mm². अच्छा, द प्रेशर ड्रॉप इन द आर्टरी इज 24 pascal. ये देखो ये एक बहुत ही बड़ा बात है, प्रेशर ड्रॉप मतलब चेंज इन प्रेशर, मतलब रो एम जी एच जो था यहाँ पे, ये जो प्रेशर ड्रॉप है तो यहाँ पे मेरा प्रेशर ड्रॉप के लिए जो प्रेशर है वो कौन सा प्रेशर है, रो एम जी एच था ना. हेलो, P1 माइनस P2 को लिया था ना, यहाँ पे इसका वैल्यू डायरेक्ट दे दिया 24 pascal. तो देखो इस पूरा का कहानी नहीं रहा, डायरेक्ट बोल दिया है, तो तुम्हें याद रखना पड़ेगा रो एम जी एच इज द प्रेशर ड्रॉप, दैट इज द 24 pascal. व्हाट इज द स्पीड ऑफ द ब्लड एट द आर्टरी. तो आर्टरी मतलब मुझे V1 पे चाहिए, ठीक है. तो V1 अब देखो मेरे पास फॉर्मूला क्या था, 2 rho mgh by अच्छा डेंसिटी ऑफ द ब्लड इज गिवन, डेंसिटी ऑफ द ब्लड इज गिवन 1.06 into 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube. तो 2 rho mgh by rho हमें क्या करना है, A2 square by A1 square minus A2 square. क्यों? क्योंकि यहाँ पे बोला है V1 पे हम लोग निकाल रहा है, मतलब हम लोग A2 लेगा, मतलब small वाला लेंगे. तो इसका मतलब हो गया 2 into 24, I think you all understand, by 1.06 into 10 to the power 3. अब देखो यहाँ पे जो है 4 का स्क्वायर 8 का स्क्वायर माइनस 4 का स्क्वायर, मिलीमीटर मिलीमीटर कट जाएगा, जाएगा ना.
यस सर.
और इसको आफ्टर कैलकुलेशन क्या लिखा है भगवान जाने, सो यू कैन कैलकुलेट इट.
सो इसका वैल्यू आएगा 2 into 24 by 1.06 10 to the power 23, ये अचार चार 16, ये कितना आएगा रे 64 - 16 ना, तो ये तुम लोग कैलकुलेशन कर लेना. समझा मेरा बात? तो ये एनसीईआरटी का क्वेश्चन है, तो बाय यूजिंग कैलकुलेटर यू कैन कैलकुलेट इट एंड देन चेक इट. कि हालांकि एनसीईआरटी शायद मुझे नहीं लगता ये कुछ दूसरा या A1 A2 डिवीजन वगैरह लेके किया है, मतलब इस एरिया को थोड़ा वो लोग दूसरा अरेंज करके किया था, but you get the same result. So just ye yaad rakhna hai, 2 pressure by rho gh, 2 p by rho gh, V1 ke liye A2 by A1 minus A2, aur V2 ke liye A2 A1 square by A1 minus A2, aur A1 square minus A2 square jo hai, wo bada area minus chota area, niche wala bada area minus chota area hoga. Thik hai?
Yes, sir.
Achha, to ye hai mera Bernoulli's theorem. खत्म हुआ. हम लोग फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट क्लास वी स्टार्ट विस्कोसिटी. ओके, एटलीस्ट एक से डेढ़ क्लास विस्कोसिटी लगेगा, एक से डेढ़ क्लास सरफेस टेंशन लगेगा, तो मानो 3 to 4 क्लास मुझे लगेगा, देन आई कैन से कि माय फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स इज कंप्लीट, देन वी स्टार्ट हीट. ओके, मींस ओके एवरीवन.
यस सर.